I was called by the office to go ahead and see if I could go back to Central African Republic, where I've been a number of times. And I knew that the Ebola outbreak was spreading and that they were looking for support. So I asked if I could be deployed to the Ebola outbreak and was accepted. And I was there for 5 weeks. This is my third viral hemorrhagic fever intervention. And I saw the benefits for both myself as a professional and personally, but as well as being a support person for the national staff on the ground. Because I know we can do it safely and I know we can do it well. And MSF has proven that to me over and over again. Started at about 6 o'clock in the morning when you went to the center to do your lab draws. So the first time that I did a blood draw with a colleague, I was kind of supporting him. It became really real at that point of how deliberate and how mindful I needed to be every step of the way. Moses is a really nice young man who's about 8 years old, and he came in. He was really, really sick, really, really sick. He came in with about 20 people one night, and all of his family had died. He had he was kind of thrown in an ambulance and sent to the center. When we identified him, he was dehydrated. He was vomiting. He was stooling. He was refusing to eat. And the team just never gave up on him. We just continued going to him day after day, hour after hour, encouraging him to eat, encouraging him to recover. He didn't look like one that was going to make it. He looked like one that was going to be not long for for this world, but he recovered and danced out, and there's some great pictures of him. So he was just an inspiration for me to be able to see where you could start and where you can end with this disease. It was the first time I've ever really realized that hope was such an important part of medicine.